We previously looked at the Quran chapter 41, verse 9 and 10, which explain how the earth was created. That happened 4.5 billion years ago. The next two verses, 11 and 12, talk about the creation of the sky. But what exactly is the sky as mentioned in the Quran? And how well does the Quran describe its formation as compared to established science? The answers to these questions are simple and elegant. So let's clarify them and be inspired by both the beauty of the Quran and its alignment with scientific understanding. After explaining how the earth was created in two eons and the mountains and sustenance formed on its surface in four overlapping eons, the Quran goes on to say, ثُمَّ أَسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ وَهِيَ دُخَانٌ. And then he applied his design to the sky, which was smoke. Verse 11 declares that God applied his design to a singular sky, sama, that was smoke. Nothing else existed, at least not in this section of the universe. It is from this smoke that the earth was formed when God commanded the earth to come into existence. In fact, science tells us the earth was initially formed from the gas and dust of a solar nebula, the dukhan or smoke described in the Quran. This verse starts right back at the beginning, before the earth was formed, and tells us what its initial materials were. Science tells us that the objects in the solar system formed due to forces of drag and gravity that cause condensation and aggregation to increase the density of matter, as opposed to processes that would diffuse matter. And he said to it and to the earth, "Come, both of you, willingly or unwillingly," to which both responded, "We do come in obedience." Verse 11 also tells us how it was created, willingly or unwillingly, an obvious reference to the forces of attraction and repulsion. So again, science confirms the Quranic explanation of the initial process of how the objects of the solar system form. But in this verse, God also commands a different sky to come into existence from the sky of smoke. What is that different sky? And he declared that they become seven skies in 2 days or eons, and imparted unto each sky its own function. Verse 12 goes on to describe that the one sky of smoke, the solar nebula, also became seven skies, each of which had amraha, its own function, order, and authority, which beautifully describes the seven other planets of our solar system, each with its own path, rotation, composition, and characteristics. And when did the earth and the seven skies or planets form? During the 2 days or eons. Logic tells us that these must be the same 2 days or eons mentioned in verse 9, since they both involve the initial formation of the earth. So based on the timing, the material, and the processes mentioned, it is clear that these verses are describing the formation of our solar system. And that would be a double subhanAllah, because according to science, not only did the earth and the seven other planets in fact form at the same time, but two of the seven planets, Neptune and Uranus, were not visible to the naked eye from the earth at the time the Quran was revealed, and telescopes powerful enough to see them had not yet been invented. From hot, rocky Mercury with almost no atmosphere, to the cold gas giant Jupiter, which is currently thought not to have a solid surface, each planet has amraha, its own orbit and characteristics. But you might ask, what about Pluto? Isn't that a planet? Shouldn't the number of other planets be 8, not 7? Well, not really. Not only is Pluto smaller than our moon, but the International Astronomical Union downgraded Pluto to a dwarf planet in 2006, because Pluto hadn't cleared its neighborhood from other objects, but instead shares its orbit with other bodies, including Neptune. In other words, Pluto does not have amraha. The point of this post is that verses 11 and 12 of chapter 41 of the Quran beautifully and accurately describe our solar system, including Earth, as being born out of a solar nebula, and that the seven other planets formed at the same time as the Earth from the same nebula. In the next video, we'll look at the spectacular final part of verse 12, which talks about sama' dunya, or the sky of the world. I hope you'll come back. I've placed interesting links on this topic in the description. If you've enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and share.